My husband always plays devil's advocate and it's exhausting. My husband is a self-proclaimed skeptic and devil's advocate. It didn't bother me for many years, because I wasn't usually the target. That has changed though, especially the last 6 months since we've both been working from home and together constantly. I've always known he doesn't like it when I complain or make negative comments. I've done a pretty good job at biting my tongue from saying how annoyed I am by a coworker, blah blah, because it won't be received well. I think it's because he can't fix the situation, and doesn't want to be my sounding board. So moving on, it's evolved to nearly every comment I make. Yesterday I said, so my sister got a 16% raise today. He does his classic head roll, pursed lips reaction, and said, that's okay, I guess. I'm like, okay. That's more than okay, it's great. A few miles down the road, I told him I had a nice chat with a coworker, who happens to be black. She told me her son said he wishes his skin was white, which broke my heart. His response. Same annoyed head roll, and says, in what context? I'm like, I don't know he's four. He says, you have to realize little kids say stuff like that all the time. Oh, and forget politics or COVID-19. Although he says we agree on both, he'll argue opposing viewpoints or demand I give him more data until he's blue in the face. I've accepted I can't talk to him about either topics. He thinks I'm overly sensitive and emotional. I am absolutely sensitive and I'm very empathetic. He criticizes me for it, when I ask him to stop automatically opposing everything I say. If I bring it up, he's automatically defensive and thinks I'm attacking him. Regardless of how nicely I phrase it. I'm craving meaningful conversation with my husband, and it seems impossible to achieve when he's always arguing my point. I enjoy conversations with like-minded people, which wouldn't include someone that's going to challenge everything I say. I think validation and support from my partner would be nice, and I don't think it's too much to ask for, is it? Devil's advocate? More like a pompous ass. Go play devil's advocate in hell. But if you'd like to talk like mature adults who value each other's opinion, we can talk. And the head roll thing makes it seem like he thinks he knows better than whoever is being discussed, but especially you. Does he care that he's coming across as extremely unattractive? You can't tell your partner that what he's doing is negatively affecting you without him getting defensive and calling you overly sensitive? That's very unhealthy. Strongly suggest counseling because you can't communicate with him. Tell him you're not in a debate class, you're in a relationship and you find his constant advocating tiring, boring and is a total turn off. To me this sounds like you want to have discussions and conversations on things and he wants to turn them into debates. What is his emotional intelligence like? He sounds exhausting. I lit into my boyfriend for devil's advocate. That's a teaching method and he's not my teacher. It's also a way for people to venture unpopular views and just saying they're playing devil's advocate. Kind of like, it was just a joke. So basically you can't talk to him about literally anything? Jesus lol, that's awful. My husband is the same way. It makes me feel invalidated and small with how frequent he does it. Communication is huge and if I am feeling unheard or like I'm talking to a brick wall or like anything I say will be counteracted, I just won't talk at all. And that's not a marriage. Your husband sounds like an exhausting, bloviating asshole. Yeah, it was fine for years because as you say you weren't the target. Well, now you are and will be, because this is who he is fundamentally. How a person treats others is almost always how he will treat you given enough time. You need a neutral third party to help open up communication. Marriage counseling is a must, but somehow I suspect he will end up devil's advocating the therapist. Nah, he's being an ass. In general, I think people who play devil's advocate are asses. I'm a big debater and I can understand wanting to bring up outside perspectives to your partner if you guys generally agree and just want to think about other ideas, but the way he's doing it is a unrelated to any such situations and B seems to just be for the purpose of shitting on you. I think you genuinely need to ask him why he feels the need to counter even just good news that's not an opinion or argumentative statement. Does he like seeing you riled up? Does he always have to be right? Why does he feel the need to qualify the things you say? With my DH going through the same thing, I've been reading the R Am I the Asshole posts to him, let him go wild getting his opinions out. It helps him to focus that energy away from me. However, I just told him I'm tired of arguing over every little thing, and he removed himself from the room. Thank goodness for a house big enough for that. Have you considered that he might just be a jerk? Ah, there's a lot of these out there. Men that no one ever told them to shut the fuck up. People who like to play devil's advocate rarely actually are. The point of playing devil's advocate is to argue an opposing viewpoint to engage in a deeper conversation on an issue. I'd try engaging in the argument. Here's how I go about it. I'd ask questions. Take your sister's raise. He says, that's good, I guess. You say, you guess. Why are you unsure? The child statement, you respond with, why don't you think it's possible that the statement is symbolic of a bigger issue? In new instances, ask, why do you feel like that, or, why do you think that? Get the other side to back up their statements. What you do is offer open-ended questions where you let him justify his statements. Cynicism is good, but constantly is a bit one-note. People like that are just hard to be around. I had a friend like that who over time drove off every friend he ever had because we all just got sick of being around him. Next time tell him he sounds like my mother-in-law, and it's the reason we're glad we're an ocean apart from her. That aside, be honest with him that this is a serious threat to your relationship. Tell him that his negative attitude towards almost everything you say makes you not want to tell him anything or even spend time around him. My first boyfriend in high school was like this. It was beyond exhausting. My condolences. Playing devil's advocate can be done without being an asshole. He needs to learn when to do it, and how to present it so it doesn't seem like he's jumping down your throat 24/7. Unless that's what he is trying to do. Please see this article lol. He sounds like a narcissist, honestly. My dad does the same thing. It's the worst, isn't it? What I've found helpful is just to stop engaging whenever he gets like that. Make it as if you've lost all interest in the topic. However, for the long term, I suggest looking to therapy, individually or for the two of you together. Therapy or divorce. Those are your options. Your husband isn't just playing devil's advocate, he don't give a fuck about you or your feelings. I read this and I'm exhausted. I can't imagine how you feel. Do you ever feel supported by him? Or do you ever have a good time with him? Fun. I dated a guy like this. He could never just believe something I said at face value. Girl, it's up to you what you can tolerate, but I'd tell that man to knock it off or get out. I once got through to a devil's advocate in my family like this. What is the function of conversation between you and I? When two family members converse, what functions does it fulfill? What are the main aims? Then established that the main function is in group bonding, since I can get life, career-relevant information, and general learning about ethics, laws, etc. from other sources that are better. Then I pointed out that the devil's advocacy was completely failing at helping me bond. So logically they were failing to communicate effectively. My husband is a self-proclaimed skeptic and devil's advocate. It didn't bother me for many years, because I wasn't usually the target. Since you've been okay with it all these years, are you surprised that he's pushing back when you find it problematic? He probably thinks you are the one being exhausting. He doesn't realize his behavior is really toxic. You need counseling, because what kind of marriage is this if you can't even speak to each other? The devil has enough advocates. I need a friend. Why are you with him? He doesn't sound like a partner at all. You can do better. He's not a devil's advocate, he's a straight-up asshole. If I were married to this person, I would insist on couples counseling. How exhausted you must be. I know people like this. They are incapable of empathy, introspection, or growth. Your husband will probably never change. You seem like a really nice person who deserves a partnership built on support and validation, not reflexive jackassery masquerading as high-concept cynicism. You have one life to live up, live it well. Don't spend all your years trying to change someone who won't change. I know it's so easy to say this on the internet to a random stranger, and I hope I am not coming off as flippant. But in my opinion, you should leave your husband and find someone who deserves you. Good luck. Courage. Less than 3. What a negative Nancy, who wants to spend time around that. He's adding nothing of value to discussions, that's so boring. People who do this seem to just love talking, but don't actually have much to say. I analyze data, it's what I do, and I would call myself an empathetic person as well. That doesn't mean that my findings are wrong, or that I can't work through my own emotions to prevent a biased outcome from occurring. Empathy doesn't mean weak, it's actually much harder to care about people and stay engaged than to tear everything down. If it was me, I would have to bring up the fact that his constant desire to argue me down no matter what signifies to me that he doesn't respect me or my intelligence. You also don't have to deal with being exhausted in your relationship. Put your foot down and tell him he needs to get his shit together. I do this a lot, and here is how my long-term girlfriend fixed it. She told me stop, she coached me on how I should respond, and she asked me to be more aware of when I do this. I was stubborn and said I'm not changing who I am. But being an ass when someone is trying to talk to me is not who I am. I just like conversational debate and realized I can find outlets to that in other places, and I should respect her stories and what she says. I'm not perfect, but I definitely have improved. The only way to fix this is to talk to him as an equal and to tell him to cut that shit out. Honestly, if he is anything like me, he will respect you being forthright rather than meek. If he doesn't change over the course of time, or at least make an effort, you can see, it's time to end things. Gonna be real, he sounds like a prick. He is exhausting, seriously. Do you really want this to be the rest of your life? I have a feeling if you tried to sit him down and talk about how you feel with his attitude or suggested therapy, he wouldn't get pissy about it. You can try though. Particularly the therapy though, because maybe this professional will get him to see how unreasonable this is for him. Does he not have anyone he can debate with? Sounds like he needs a friend to get this stuff out of his system so he doesn't do it to you. Be careful or you will lose yourself. I sure did in this type of situation. Finally feeling like my old self again now that it is over. Take care of you. I work in research at an equity and I often have the head advisor play devil's advocate with the research I send him, and similarly, I play devil's advocate a lot with the rest of the team. In those cases it's important, we need to make sure we have an answer to all of the questions that a client might have, relevant or not. Similarly, I'll play devil's advocate with friends at times if they're asking for help with a big decision, just to make sure they've thought about all angles and implications. Those are cases where it's fine to do what he's doing, but doing it all the time. That just sounds tiring, and there's really no reason to turn everything, every throwaway comment into a debate. He sounds like someone who likes drama for the sake of drama. Why do you want to be with someone who won't talk to you about your annoyances? I get not wanting to gripe and complain all the time, but that seems like a red flag to me. Partners are supposed to be supportive and kind. Why are you with someone you can't even have a conversation with, someone who doesn't support you? I understand I'm generalizing, but I think it applies to your situation. Women initiate way more divorces than men, and they won't leave even when it's bad. They'll just cut the engines until the plane crashes into the mountain. Is it possible that your husband feels that you expect a certain reaction from him when you tell him things? He may be rebelling against this. Maybe he wants the freedom to not always see things the way you do. I would ask him. Yeah, he's enjoying poking the bear and is having fun at your expense. He knows exactly what he's doing and he knows exactly how you feel about it, and he doesn't care. Think about that really hard. A soundboard for you. Isn't that the purpose of a partnership, so that you can both confide in each other? I don't know, it seems like he's an asshole who's up his own butt. Personally, I would not survive in a relationship like this. My husband sometimes plays devil's advocate when I might have not thought a point through. Usually he does this so that when I am talking on that topic with somebody else that I have a more consistent point. But honestly, what good is a relationship if you can't even have a conversation? I was partnered with someone like that. I too found it exhausting. It doesn't necessarily make them a terrible person. But I just could not spend the rest of my life in one tedious Socratic argument after another over even the most mundane who gives a shit issues. I ran. Totally incompatible. Tell him the devil doesn't need one, just take a look at the year we're having. I think he just likes being a troll. Oh gosh, my closest friend does this, and we have drifting apart cause of this. I cannot share anything with him, complain about something or talk about someone. He apparently is being fair and unbiased, so argues everything with me. I actively pushed myself away after it became toxic AF. He thinks he's smarter than you. My husband does this too, he calls it giving perspective. Drives me crazy. I've become fond of the phrase I've read once, though, was simply, he has enough of those already. Devil's advocates, it's a nice little reality check to be like, okay, but what would you say if you weren't just trying to be an ass? Dear God, this man sounds insufferable. Usually the whole devil's advocate thing is just used in arguments or debates, but he's doing it when you're happy about something too. Like at that point he just lacks basic empathy and genuinely can't hold a conversation. This comes from deep-seated insecurity. If he knew he was smarter than everyone, he wouldn't be trying to prove it all the time. It's probably a combination of not respecting you and needing to dismiss you so he doesn't feel challenged. This is not an easy fix that will go away with a heart-to-heart. It requires serious therapy from him and strategic engagement from you. From your comments, you seem to be avoidant, and all this will do is make it worse. I urge you to get individual counseling until you have the self-confidence to demand he go to counseling as well.